हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन क्लास फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ बीए पार्ट 3 इंग्लिश लिटरेचर। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अ पोएम दैट इज प्रेस्क्राइब्ड इन योर सिलेबस, वीमेन इन डच पेंटिंग कंपोज्ड बाय यूनिस डिसूजा। सो स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू कैन सी ऑन योर स्क्रीन देयर इज एन इमेज ऑफ अ पेंटिंग। दिस is a Dutch painting made by Peter de Hoogh, and there is another painting of a mother nursing her children. Yet there is another image of the same work done by a housewife, and here is another painting in which a mother is cooking food for her children. The poem that is prescribed in your syllabus is composed by Eunice D'Souza. Eunice D'Souza was born in 1940 and was died in 2017. She was an Indian English language poet, literary critic and novelist. Among her notable books of poetry are Women in Dutch Painting, that was published in 1988, Ways of Belonging, Nine Indian Women Poets, These My Words, and Learn from the Almond Leaf. She published two novels, Dengalok, that was published in 2001, and Dev and Simran, that was published in 2003. And was also the editor of a number of anthologies on poetry, folk tales, and literary criticism. She was born on August 1, 1940 in Pune in India, and was died on July 29, 2017 in Mumbai, India. Eunice D'Souza was born and grew up in Pune in a Goan Catholic family. She studied English literature with an MA from the Marquette University in Wisconsin and a PhD from the University of Mumbai. She taught English at St. Xavier's College, Mumbai, and was head of the department until her retirement. She was involved in the well-known literary festival Ithaca, organized at the college. She was involved in theater, both as actress and director, and began writing novels with her first Dengalok, published in 2001. She also wrote four children's books. So as you know that Eunice D'Souza was a teacher, critic, poet, writer for children, novelist, and she is a well-known and much appreciated poet, whose distinctive voice with its ironic and cynical inflections, as seen in her first collection, Fix, that was published in 1979. She has become softer in subsequent volumes, but continues nonetheless to provoke thought and introspection. Much of D'Souza's verse consists of short, imagistic pieces that create a picture and embroider it. Her tone is observant and seemingly detached, with an underlying anger at society's structure, which can almost be overlooked. So finally, we can say that she is a feminist writer, and in this poem, Women in Dutch Painting, she dedicated this poem to Melanie Salgado. Melanie Salgado, image you can see on your screen. Melanie Salgado was Eunice D'Souza's student, and she is herself a poet who writes in an often acerbic tone about women's issues and the social concern and pressures associated with being female in the patriarchal Christian world to which she belonged. Melanie Salgado was born in 1956, and nowadays she is living in London. This poem, Women in Dutch Painting, is the title poem of the eponymously named collection published in 1988. Her social concerns continue to be visible, but there is a softening of tone and a measure of acceptance visible which were not aspects of fix. To better understand the poem, it is necessary to look at some paintings of women by Dutch painters such as Johannes Vermeer, Peter de Hoogh, and Rembrandt. Now I will give you a brief introduction of these writers. Johannes Vermeer was a Dutch Baroque period painter who specialized in domestic interior scenes of middle class life. Peter de Hoogh, whose painting you can see on your screen, Peter de Hoogh was a Dutch Golden Age painter, contemporary of Johannes Vermeer. Peter de Hoogh was famous for his works of quiet domestic scenes with an open doorway. Rembrandt was a Dutch draughtsman, painter, and printmaker. He is considered one of the greatest visual artists in the history of art. Now, as we discuss about the poem Women in Dutch Painting by Eunice D'Souza, so Eunice D'Souza has written this poem in free verse, and in the next video we are going to study the poem's text. So Eunice D'Souza, this poem, before understanding or before studying the poem, we should note some of the artistic features in Dutch painting about how women are shown in these paintings. So this is a very important task that we should do before, and that we should observe before starting to study the poem. So in the next video we are going to study the poem's text, Women in Dutch Painting. So that's all for today, students. Thank you all.